Disney is dead. It's really hard to fathom how Disney died. You are the largest corporation in the world. You have the biggest fan base ever. And yet you pander to a small minority of SJWs that don't even visit your parks. All they want to do is bitch and moan about things because they are insecure about themselves. They just want to see the world burn. It's very unfortunate because Disney has been my life since the start. I remember watching your movies ever since I was a kid, popping it on TV, the VCR, VHS, whatever you call it. I remember, you know, my kids will never get to experience VHS tapes, but I did back in the day when Disney came out with the early 2000s movies. I remember when I went to therapy, and I was 17 years old. This was in therapy. I was around 17, trying to mourn the loss of my father, and they had this old TV in the therapy room. And as I was waiting, there was a VHS tape of The Lion King playing. And, you know, at 17 years old, teenagers are rebellious. Hey, I don't want to watch this baby stuff. No, I sat there and I watched it. I watched it and I was deeply into it, just loving it on this old, disgusting TV that you could barely see the quality. And you know what? It brought me so much nostalgia because that's what Disney does. It brings nostalgia. And ever since I was a kid, I have been a massive fan of history. Historical elements. I remember my father always teaching me about presidents and forts and the military. I would remember him taking me on nature trails and teaching me about plants and our history. And I remember my father would always really get me into this stuff. So I guess that's why I became such a massive fan of Disney in the first place, because everything that my dad taught me is what Disney kind of also taught me. Tom Sawyer, you know, all of this historical stuff, Huckleberry Finn. My dad always would read stories of Huckleberry Finn to me and Tom Sawyer. And I remember always going to the fort, Fort Langhorne, and Tom Sawyer's island, and shooting the guns off, actually pretending to be a soldier in that time. It was a deeply entrancing experience that made me feel like I was a part of the world that Disney was creating. I loved Carousel of Progress, and unfortunately, I never experienced Carousel of Progress as a kid. I experienced it when I was already in my mid-teens. I believe I was 15, 16 when I first did Carousel of Progress. I was blown away. It was a Walt Disney classic. To this day, I try riding Carousel of Progress every time I go to the Magic Kingdom. It is a deeply rich experience that everyone should experience every single time they go to the Magic Kingdom. Disney held a place in my heart. When I go to Universal Studios with my family, I don't get the same feeling as when I go to Disney. When I go to Disney, I always have a smile on my heart, on my face, but I also have a warm feeling in my heart. When I go to Universal, I always get this butterfly feeling in my heart where I'm nervous of how the day will pan out because it's more of a thrill park and it's built on Hollywood action movies where they thrust you around and stuff. Never do I smile when I go to Universal Studios. It's always, ooh, what am I going to ride? What am I going to ride? Is it going to be this thrill ride or is it going to be this thrill ride? Never am I just happy when I go to Universal. When I go to Disney every single time, I just have this look on my face like, we're here, we are back to the most magical place on earth. Because Disney is not only theme park entertainment. I don't care what you say. It is art. It is a world. And Disney has always deeply not only made me happy, but it has made tons of people happy. And I've said this before, Disney has saved me from suicidal thoughts. My early teens, even to today, I've had suicidal thoughts because I struggle with fitting in. I struggle with, you know, trying to fit in this world. And And unfortunately, it's sometimes really stressful. It's sometimes really hard, especially breakups with girlfriends, not a lot of friends, stuff like that. But going to a Disney park always makes me so happy. It makes me forget about my suicidal thoughts, and it makes me think about, you know, I'm having a great day today. I am going on Splash Mountain, and I'm going to experience this one-of-a-kind, beautiful attraction. I love Disney. I do. Because Disney's like no other. Where can you go to a museum and also a theme park at the same time? Where can you really truly experience that? No other. And that's what makes Disney above all. But Disney's dead. Disney has officially died. They have pandered to an SJW audience that doesn't even care about the parks. Disney is not listening to the outcry of true fans that want to preserve Splash Mountain for the Black community. We wish to create a new Princess and the Frog attraction, built from the ground up, honoring Black people. But Disney still chooses to ignore the fans. They ignored us when we outcried during the Star Wars sequels. They ignored us when we asked why they're changing the Pirates of the Caribbean redhead scene. They have ignored us time and time again. But now, them removing Splash Mountain is the final nail on the coffin. They have officially died as a company. When they make this move, Disney is dead. There is no more Disney for me. There is no more happiness in my heart. Because when Disney removes Splash Mountain, they remove themselves from my heart, and never again will I go to Disney. I will go to Universal Studios, this thrill park, where my heart will continue to have butterflies, and it will continue to be just kind of nervous inside. Never will I have that smile again on my face. Never again will I be happy, filled with joy, like Disney once did. No. I will be going to a park that is just theme park entertainment, purely. Some of it is beautiful theme park entertainment, like Harry Potter, but most of it is just 3D madness. Unfortunately, Universal just isn't like Disney. And sadly, I will find myself going to those parks a lot more, because Disney has died. And we can still fight. We can still sign the petitions. We can support one another. We need to save Disney. Disney is dead, but they can get out of that grave. They can dig out and triumph once again. But unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, Disney right now is in SJW territory, and it would take a miracle for them to change. So right now, we just have to pray. We have to close and bow our heads. Because Disney is in the dark times right now. It's very unfortunate, but that's how it's become. We need to sign the petitions on change.org, Save Splash Mountain. We need to follow each other and grow as a fan base for Walt, for the Disney Corporation, for the company. But unfortunately, we are in dark times, and I really, truly see that whatever we do will not fix this damaged company. It is damaged beyond recognition, and I just have to come out and say that Disney is dead. Now, prove me wrong, ladies and gentlemen. Maybe Disney will crawl out, but at the moment, I don't think that's possible. Go to change.org, leave a like, comment down below, subscribe to whatever the heck you want to do, and goodbye. Bye, everyone!
Thanks for watching, guys, and don't forget to leave a like on the video.